Hello guys, my name is Viktoria Pavlov. I'm the Photoshop artist. Welcome to my studio. A few days ago, I uploaded my painting I created in Adobe Fresco on my Twitter, and you guys asked me to record a tutorial how I created this art. So guys, let's do it today. I have opened Adobe Fresco, also I have created white screen document. By default in Fresco, we have two layers. One layer is simple background layer and top layer, second layer is empty layer. Now, I will click on live brushes, just like this. I will click on watercolor brushes. And here, guys, I have my favorite watercolor round, watercolor wash soft brush. I will increase size of my brush. I will increase flow to 100%. I will increase water flow to 100% and I will change color of my brush to light blue color. Using this brush, I will create my sky. I will apply a few brush strokes of this beautiful blue color. Now guys, I will change to red color and using same brush, I will add a few splashes of this beautiful color. If I will change color of my brush to yellow, I will add a few splashes of this beautiful yellow color as well. Now guys, time to switch color of my brush to white. And using this brush with smaller size, I will add a few details to my sky. Beautiful, I love it. Now, I will switch back to my blue color. I will bring size of my brush down and I will fix my horizon line just like this. Now I'm happy with my sky. Time to change color of my brush to brown and bringing size of my brush down will help me to create this beautiful horizon just like guys, did you notice that Fresco blends all colors for me? I don't need to apply any extra steps to blend my colors. Fresco does the job. Now I have this beautiful, misty, mystery-looking horizon line with this beautiful sky. Time to change color of my brush to blue. Maybe lighter shade of blue. I will increase size of my brush, not too much, and I will create my ocean, just like this. How beautiful is it, guys? If I will bring size of my brush down, I will create a little bit more misty looking ocean, just like this. Now, time to switch color of my brush to green. And using this color, I will add a few extra details to my water. Nothing is too complicated, something like this. Time to switch back to yellow color, just like this. And using this color, I will create my shoreline. Just like this. And again, Fresco does the job. I don't need to apply any extra steps to blend my colors. Fresco does the job. And now I will switch color of my brush to red. And using this color, I will add a few more details to my shoreline. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Maybe a few splashes of green color will add more details to my art. Now, I will create a new empty layer. I will switch to another brush. I will switch to watercolor round detail brush. And I will change color of my brush to dark brown color. Also, I will bring size of my brush down. Now, guys, what I will do? I will change value of my water flow. I will bring value of water flow to 32. Or a little bit more or less, it's up to you. And using this brush, I will create my bench, just like this. Look at this. Nothing too complicated. Switching color of my brush to light brown, almost orange color, and bringing size of my brush down will help me to add a few details to my bench, just like this. Now, I will change color of my brush to black. I will bring size of my brush down about 7, and I will add a few details to my bench. White color will help me to add a few more details. How beautiful is it? Now, I will create a new empty layer. I will switch to our brown color we used before. And using small size of my brush, I will create my tree, just like this. Guys, you can create your tree in any shape you like. Everything is up to you. Also, you can change between bigger and smaller size of your brush at any time. It's your creation, it's your art. Use your imagination. You can create your tree in completely unexpected shape. And I can guarantee your tree will look amazing. Just like this. You can create as many branches as you like. And again, it's your creation. It's your art. Everything is possible. It's your vision. No rules in here. Guys, Fresco does the job again. I know I'm repeating myself, but this is amazing. Guys, we are working with watercolor brushes digitally, and look at this. It's like a traditional watercolor paintbrush. All colors blend together so amazingly perfect. I love it. Now, I will change color of my brush to lighter shade of same color, and I will add a few details to my tree. Just like this. Nothing is too complicated. Now, I will create a new empty layer on top of my all other layers. I will switch to watercolor with a spatter brush, and using a light shade of yellow color with bigger size of my brush, about 1, maybe 257, I will create a first layer of my leaves. Just look at this. Guys, how beautiful is it? Changing color of my brush to red will help me to add a few red leaves to my tree. Just like this. Also, I will add a few splashes of green color to my art. Just like this. If I will bring size of my brush down, I will create smaller leaves. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Now, I will create a new empty layer. I will switch to yellow or red color, and I will add a few splashes of yellow color to my art. I don't like it. I will undo it. I will increase size of my brush, just like this, and a few splashes. Yes, 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 just like this. Guys, the beauty of working with layer is I can bring down opacity of my layer, just like this. And now I love my red trees. I can add a few splashes of this color outside of my tree. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Also, I can add a few leaves under my tree. Using same brush with same color, I will add a few splashes of red color under my tree, just like this. Maybe a little bit green color. Yes, yes, yes. I love it, guys. Now, what I would like to do, I would like to add a new empty layer. I will switch to black color. Also, I will switch to a watercolor round detail brush, and I will bring size of my brush down. Also, guys, I will bring a water flow value down to probably 10, let's see. And using this brush, I will add a few details to my bench. Yes, just like this. Yes, I love it. And also, guys, of course, I can bring down opacity of my layer at any time. Also, using this brush, I can add a few details to my tree. Let's zoom out. Just a little bit more branches. Yes. Changing color of my brush to dark brown will help me to create more beautiful and realistic looking branches. Yes, just like this. And I love it. What can I do now, guys? I would like to add a few details to my water. I will create a new empty layer on top of my water layer. And switching color of my brush to white will help me to add a few details to my ocean. Look at this. Just like this, guys. And again, nothing is too complicated. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. And if I will change color of my brush to dark brown color, I will add a few details to my horizon line. Just like this. How beautiful is it, guys? I love it, love it, love it. Just a little bit, not too much, guys. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. And same with shoreline. I will switch to dark yellow orange color, and I will add a few splashes of this color to my shoreline, just like this. Guys, believe or not, we are almost done. I would like to add a few details under my bench and around my tree. To do so, I will create a new empty layer on top of my all layers. I will switch to back to watercolor with a spatter brush. I will bring size of my brush down, just like that. I will increase flow. I will specify water flow value to 64. And using this brush, I will add a few details around my bench, just like that. Oops, sorry, I dropped my pencil. And around my tree, just like this. Beautiful. Now, guys, I will create a new empty layer on top of my old layers. I will switch to yellow color, bright yellow color. I will increase size of my brush, and using this brush, I will add a few details to my grass, just like this. Beautiful. Also, I can bring down opacity of this layer as well. And this is what I wanted to share with you guys. Now you can see how easy you can create a very beautiful watercolor art in Adobe Fresco. And the best part, Fresco does the job. Please go download Adobe Fresco, create something, and share your creation with me. I will be super happy to see what you created after this tutorial. Guys, thank you so much for your time. Super appreciated. Appreciated of all your support. And I will see you later, guys. Thank you. Bye.